For a second time this election season, the Hawaii Democratic Party has filed a complaint against a candidate who is running on their party ticket. Chris Manabat, who won the primary for the Eva House District, is the man in question. Breanne Randall has more on our top story.
Joe Manabat swears to be a Democrat, but the party says he's not, a debate that could end up in court.
The values of the Democratic Party is something I've always held close.
Values that are being put into question for first-time candidate 28-year-old Chris Manabat.
When he filed his nomination paper on May 30 that he's a member of the Democratic Party, that was a lie.
Manabat and Rose Martinez challenged each other in the primary election for House District 40, which represents Eva, Eva Beach, and Iroquois Point. Manabat squeezed out the win by less than 200 votes.
Since I went through the primary and I won the primary election, I honestly think that she is just having a hard time letting go.
Martinez has filed a complaint with the Office of Elections that he should not have been allowed on the ballot since he is not a party member in good standing.
A candidate doing such act is a blatant disrespect to the system, to the voters, to the people of Hawaii.
But Manabat says he believed he was a registered Democrat at the time he filed his nomination papers.
I thought I already registered. I signed up at a Democratic caucus years beforehand. There was a time when I was getting even updates from them.
The Democratic Party filed their own complaint June 13th, telling the elections office Manabat was ineligible.
It's frustrating, certainly for the party, for Mr. Manabat, as well as more particularly for those other five Democrats who were legally recorded as Democrats.
The Office of Elections told the Democratic Party in June that any objection would need to be filed in circuit court. But no complaint was made to remove Manabat from the ballot, and no challenge was made following his win in the primary election.
Well, then somebody did not do the job here. The Democratic Party could have done something.
Earlier this year, the Democratic Party rejected Laura Thielen's request to run for state Senate on their ticket. She went ahead anyway and won the Democratic primary and is on the ballot for the general. The Office of Elections says Manabat's name will also appear on the ballot in November.
I want to do what's best for the party. You know, I hope that if I am elected that we can move on from all of this.
The elections office has sent the complaints against Manabat to the state's attorney general. Breanne Randall, KHON2 News, Hawaii's news leader.